So a police detective in Springfield, Massachusetts has been fired after posting support for Black Lives Matter. Now, I'm going to give you all the context to this. I'll give you my takeaway at the end of it. But here, let me just start with the headline here. So this from Boston.com. Springfield police fire detective after pro-Black Lives Matter post. So they go on to say here, Mass Live reported Wednesday that Florissa Fuentes, a 30-year-old detective who was recently promoted in the Special Victims Unit, was fired by department leaders on June 19th after a May 29th post on her personal Instagram account while off-duty. The photo, which Fuentes later deleted, showed her niece during a protest in Atlanta following the killing of George Floyd by police in Minneapolis, holding a sign that said, "Shoot the F back," while another person's sign read, "Who do we call when the murderers wear the badge?" Quote, "After I posted it, I started getting calls and texts from coworkers," Fuentes told Mass Live. "I was initially confused, but then I realized that they thought I was being anti-cop. I wasn't. I was just supporting my niece's activism. I had no malicious intent, and I wouldn't put a target on my own back. I'm out there on the streets every day, like everyone else." So this is... She ended up deleting the Instagram post. Now, first of all, I guess... I don't know. Unfortunately, the part of the advice here has to be, if you're worried about your job, keep your post private. Don't add people at work. another piece of advice. But she ended up deleting the Instagram post, even though I don't think there's much wrong with it. She's supporting her niece. I understand the worry around, you know, shoot the F back. I get it. But fine. She deleted the post. And she also apologized on Facebook. Once I get this out of the way. So she also apologized on Facebook. And look at the reaction here. So this is her post on Facebook apologizing. Saying, "To my fellow officers, I recently shared a post that a family member had posted of themselves protesting the recent death of George Floyd. I did not share this photo with any malicious intent, and I should have thought of how others might perceive it. I apologize to all of those who I've offended. I am not anti-cop. I wear my badge proudly and have committed my life and career to being a police officer." So, very cordial apology. She apologized, deleted the post. The response, though. So, it was enough for a few who responded, "I'm good, bro, no worries, and no, we are not all blue and need to support each other." But for others, the apology prompted more vitriol than the original post. "Keep your apology. You're too dangerous or too stupid to safely associate with," one fellow officer wrote. The apology was eventually taken down. Fuentes said she was told to keep her head down by supervisors and ride out the negativity in the office when she typically preferred to be on the streets. So, she took the post down, apologized, nothing's wrong with the apology, and still got shit for it. Now, this is the kind of thing where we shouldn't expect cops to be this fragile. And unfortunately, this is not surprising. Unfortunately, this response, from what we've seen of how cops act in public, this kind of response to even an apology is not surprising. But it should be surprising. This is the kind of police culture that you can't simply change with reform. How many times have we discussed reform? How many times has actual reform been implemented? You saw it in Minneapolis. They did all the Obama-era police reforms. It didn't do anything. The issue is the cops have too much power. You can't simply change the police culture. It is what it is. So the only thing that you can do, the only power that we do have, is to defund them. Now, I will give some credit here to at least cops that are, again, afraid to speak out publicly, but they know it's gone too far. So here, fellow officer Fuentes, who asked to remain anonymous for fear of retribution, said he believes favoritism is rampant at the department, and Claprude, who is the police chief, or police commissioner, had the option of extending Fuentes' probation period as opposed to firing her. Quote, "There's a lot of officers who are afraid to speak up about this issue and don't want to be targeted as well. Although we agree punishment should have happened," which I still, like, the fact that they're, even the good cops are in agreement that, oh, she definitely had to be punished for supporting Black Lives Matter. "Although we agree punishment should have happened, she owned up to it immediately and said sorry, and she was sincere," the officer said. There are officers who lied on police reports. This is the main point here. There are officers who lied on police reports and have done worse things, yet they remain employed. So think of all of the crap that cops do, and much of it on camera, but a lot of the stuff not on camera, and they get to keep their positions. But here is a post on her personal Instagram page supporting her niece in her activism, and she gets fired over it. This is the kind of thing you just can't, you can't reform out of. You have to take their power away. This is the police culture, unfortunately. There is no easy way to change police culture. You just need less cops. You need less cops. You need to move much of the responsibilities into other areas. You can't have this one-size-fits-all force that deals with everything from mental health calls to domestic disputes to homelessness issues to the war on drugs, whatever. I mean, there are many ways to really tackle each of these issues. I mean, for example, the war on drugs, we should completely end that. But when it comes to mental health calls, public health officials, people that are specialized in those sorts of calls, should be the ones that are called to respond to those situations. But this is the only way out of it, is to ensure that cops don't have as much power as they currently do. And that's why the answer to all of this is always defund the police. You can't simply change the culture. The culture is what it is. It has deep roots. You got to defund the police. Celeste says if it was a male cop, he wouldn't have been fired. I don't agree with that. I think he also likely would have been fired. I mean, the other part of that story that I guess I should have mentioned was that she was fairly new. She had joined the force in 2018, was still on, I think she had just left the probationary period. So she had been there for over, I guess, 6 months or 3 months. If it's someone who had been there a lot longer, then yeah, it's possible they would have not been fired because they had more seniority. But somebody who's new, they're gonna, you know, be very critical of you, especially when you're joining a new group and they have a certain culture, they have a certain way of looking at things. If already they're seeing that a new recruit is not in line with how they feel about certain issues, I guess in this case, you know, you have to hate Black Lives Matter to be able to be a part of the group, then they're gonna make you an outcast. And they have no problem firing you if you haven't been there that long.